Well, hello, first grade friends, and welcome to Monday. It is Monday, November 9th. I hope you all had an awesome weekend. I know I did. I enjoyed some time outside and getting to watch the Razorbacks win. That was really exciting. And just enjoying time at home. So today is reading group day. I can't wait to see you for your normal reading group time. Don't forget to bring your dry erase board and marker from your curriculum bag. If you do not have that, you can use a pencil and paper, but we're going to do a little bit of writing today. In phonics this week, we're going to review this in our reading lesson today, but in phonics this week, we are going to be looking at Magic E once again, but this time, Magic E is helping a different vowel to say its name. It's the vowel I. So we know the short sound for I is I, but this week we're going to learn about how if there is a silent E at the end of the word and there's the letter I, then the silent E is going to help the I say its name. We'll review all of that in reading group today. In your math this week, you're still working on that addition and subtraction within 10, but you're also working on above 10. And last week you talked about how to make a group of 10 and how that can help you make a teen number and how that can help you be able to count easier and add and subtract easier if you know how to make a group of 10. So keep working on that this week. In reading today, we are going to be finishing up a little bit from our lesson on Friday, and we're going to learn a new word, the word observe. And then you're going to start with day one of your new fluency passage. In science today, we're going to continue looking at animals. I can't wait to see what interesting things you will learn today. And then it's one of your favorites. Today is PE day. Today's question of the day is, who is the next president of the United States? You may know from last week that we talked about Election Day. You talked about it in library last week. And then the week before, we learned all about elections and the role of president or the job of president. And we know that there were two main people who were trying to become president. There was Donald Trump, who is our current president, and then Joe Biden. And so regardless of if you do or do not like either one of these men, we know it's important to respect them because they are the leaders of our country. And so we want to make sure that no matter who is in charge, that we respect them and follow their lead. So I want to know, do you know who won the election? It took them a while to count all the votes and figure out who the winner was, but this weekend they told us who our next president will be. Some of you may have talked about this with your parents, but if you did not know, they said that Joe Biden is our new president. So he will not start just yet. Donald Trump is still our current president, and he will continue working. We will continue to follow his lead and respect him until the end, towards the end of January. And that's when Joe Biden will become our new president. So I hope that you've talked about this a little bit with your family, but it's important to know who our president is because we want to make sure and respect them. And it's just good to know who is leading our country. Well, friends, I hope you have a wonderful Monday. Don't forget to answer that question of the day. You can answer it by choosing the multiple choice. So you either choose Donald Trump or Joe Biden. Who is our new president? Did you just hear what I said? Okay. Hope you were listening because that is how you're going to answer the question of the day today. I will see you at Reading Group, and I hope you have a great Monday. Bye, guys.